Hi everyone, welcome back. We are continuing on in stoichiometry, specifically limiting reagents. Today we're going to be tackling a combustion reaction. So dust off your ideal gas law. We are going to be using it multiple times. So today our combustion reaction involves the combustion of octane. Now combustion reactions always react some kind of hydrocarbon with oxygen and they form carbon dioxide and water vapor. So in our case, we have 250 milliliters of octane. That's at 25 degrees C and 1.5 atmospheres. It's going to react with 1,500 milliliters of oxygen, also at 25 degrees C, and at 2.2 times 10 to the third torr. What we need to do is find the final pressure in torr of the carbon dioxide formed. Now it gives us a little bit more information. We are assuming the carbon dioxide collected is collected in a 2-liter container and it is at 35 degrees Celsius. We have been given a chemical equation, which is great, but we never assume that it's balanced. So let's make sure this is a balanced equation. Of course, it is not a balanced equation. So I'm gonna balance out, let's see, carbons, then hydrogens, and finally oxygens. Now, if you do not like to have fractions when you're balancing chemical equations, please feel free to multiply everything through by 2. We will end up with the same numbers in the end. As a review, here's my ideal gas law, and I have also included several values for R, so we have those handy to plug in. The most important thing when doing ideal gas law is to make sure that your units that you use for your R match up with the units you're going to use when you're plugging into the variables. If they do not match, you will not get the right answer. So let's determine our limiting reagent. Of course, we need to go to moles. As always, stoichiometry loves those moles. So let's determine moles of our octane first. So I am simply plugging in numbers that were given to me in the problem. I was given 1.5 atmospheres. I was given 0.25 liters. And of course my temperature, I'm always gonna convert to Kelvin. Now notice with my units, I have atmospheres, liters, and Kelvin. So for my R, I have chosen an R that has units that match up with the units I have plugged into my ideal gas law. Of course, I'm gonna solve for N, the number of moles. Here are my moles of octane. I'm gonna do the same thing with oxygen. Here's my calculation for oxygen. Again, I'm just gonna take the numbers that were given to me in the problem. Here are my torr. I did convert milliliters to liters, and of course I converted Celsius to Kelvin. I'm gonna make sure my R matches. So I have liters, torr, and Kelvin. Notice the value here is different from the one I used for my octane. Here are my number of moles of oxygen. Great, now I just need to run a test to see which one is my limiting reactant. So I'm gonna take my moles of octane, and I'm gonna say if I'm gonna use all my moles of octane, how many moles of oxygen will I need? Here's my mole ratio to convert between moles of octane to moles of oxygen. I am going to need 0.19 moles of oxygen. So if I look and see how many moles of oxygen I actually have, you can see I only have 0.17. I do not have enough. Oxygen will limit me. So oxygen will be my limiting reagent. Again, I'm going to put my big box around here with my big LR to make sure that I use the correct number of moles moving forward. Now I simply need to use my limiting reagent to determine how many moles of carbon dioxide are formed. Here are my moles of oxygen, my mole ratio. This is how many moles of carbon dioxide I'm going to form. Of course, the problem does not ask us for moles of carbon dioxide. It asks us for the pressure of the carbon dioxide, and specifically, it wants us to find the pressure in torr. So using my ideal gas law again, my pressure is my variable. That's what I'm trying to find. The problem told me it was going to be in 2 liters. I have calculated my moles of carbon dioxide formed. The problem also told me what temperature, so there's my temperature. Again, I'm going to choose an R that matches with all the units I have. So I have moles, I have Kelvin, and I have liters. Of course, I want my pressure to be in torr as specified by the problem. So this is the R I'm going to use. I plug those in. Here is my final pressure of carbon dioxide. I should have three significant figures in my final answer. So my final answer is 1.09 times 10 to the third torr of carbon dioxide. If you need help with significant figures, I will be making a video of how I determine significant figures for all my calculations for this problem. The most common mistake that I have seen on students' papers is simply not using the correct R for whatever their variables are. So make sure you keep track of those units and make sure those units match. Thanks so much for watching.